relevant, reliable, and researched. This is Experts on Call, the show focused on delivering leading-edge news and information on today's most beneficial products and services. This is Experts on Call on AM 650.
Welcome back to the program. Sterling Fox and Tony Gioventu from the Condominium Homeowners Association of BC, where he is the executive director, joined in studio by strata lawyer Adrian Murray. And just before we get back to our segment, we did promise you we would give you the email address to this program. Love to hear from you and love to really tackle some of the issues you present to us. The address is radio@keypacific.com. Key Pacific is a little tricky. It's like Lonsdale Key or New Westminster Key. It's Quay Pacific. So radio@quaypacific.com, and we read everything we get. And back to our email du jour from Doris in North Vancouver, who basically wants to know, Adrian, the lawyer, how can her strata council take away a parking space that she thinks she bought? So let's talk a little bit about some of the fundamentals here. The right of a strata council to execute this decision in which they have seen a parking spot Doris never uses, and they're going to give it to somebody else because they're getting a little jammed for spots.
Well, we've talked about the different ways it may be allocated and limited common property developer's lease, but let's say it is just simply common property. The parking area is common property. Doris was told she had three parking spaces by the seller, maybe because the seller had the three parking spaces. But when we've done all the research, it's simply common property.
Okay.
Under the Strata Property Act, the Strata Council is responsible for allocating the use of common property. They can provide exclusive use to an owner for up to a year. They can renew it, and they can put conditions on it. So it may be that the seller of this unit to Doris had been allocated those three units by the Strata Council and continued to use them while they owned it. Doris now owns it and initially had the use of three parking, but the council now, under the Strata Property Act, has a legal right to withdraw the use on reasonable notice. Some questions I would ask if I was Doris, if the Strata Council came to me and said,
we're taking
away one of the spots,
right,
as well, why me?
Right.
Are there any others that you can take away?
Mm-hmm.
Perhaps reasonable notice needs to be longer than 2 weeks or 3 weeks. On the other hand, if Doris isn't using it, it's simply a superfluous space and, mm-hmm. and there's a use for it, maybe 2 weeks or 3 weeks reasonable notice is fair and that there are no other spaces. So the Strata Council may be right in looking at this space and wanting it back from Doris. On the other hand, certainly, again, that's an assumption, or we wouldn't want to jump to that conclusion. We'd want to be asking those questions. If I was Doris, why me?
Right, exactly. Okay. And Tony, what's the remedy here? So that everybody gets to live happily ever after. I mean, ultimately, is this something that Adrian is going to march down to courthouse and take in front of a judge? Or is there a way of dealing with this shy of all of the legal action?
Well, there's certainly a potential for a court dispute if we're talking about someone's allocated property use has been taken away from them,
right,
unreasonably. I think that's that is going to be the argument that's made. But I think the best remedy for strata corporations is prevent these disputes in the first place and create parking plans. Source out all the information, find out who's been allocated what, find out if leases actually ever were created under the original development, go back to owners, source out, see if they have documents, contact the developer's lawyer to see what was issued, if they were ever issued, and basically reestablish all of this information so that you have a clear picture on what you're dealing with. It's the confusion around this. Clearly, out of this email, what I see is confusion.
Yeah, absolutely.
And it's about confusion about unreliable or information that is not verified whether it's true or not.
Right.
And the best way to deal with that is basically create parking plans, create storage locker plans, and deal with all those allocations, because if you do it up front, it will eliminate a significant number of problems in the future for your owners, headaches for the strata council and the property manager, much easier for sales with respects to conveyance of strata lots, renters, tenants, everybody uses parking, relies upon it.
Mm.
Many developments have a shortage of parking, so having a clear parking plan is pretty important.
Now, you mentioned user fees during the break just a couple of minutes ago. How would that apply in this context, or would it at all?
Well, strata corporations have the ability to charge user fees for a common property. So they either have to create it in their rules or in their bylaws that they're going to charge a specific fee. And we, certainly we have strata corporations in the downtown core who have 10 extra parking spaces no one's using. And they actually have created more of a system of fairness for access, but they've created a revenue source. The additional parking spaces are available on a first-come, first-served basis, and they're available at a rate of $50 a month, $100 a month, $200 a month, even more. Same thing for storage lockers. So the user fees have to be in ratified rules, or they have to be in bylaws, one of the two. Council can't just impose a user fee. The owners physically have to ratify these things at general meetings. So the user fees themselves, we also have other kinds of user fees that are popping up as we're starting to see changes in the types of cars that are built. We have electric cars now.
Oh,
people
sure.
need charging stations,
yes,
right?
Yes, exactly. Yeah.
And so we actually have manufacturers and providers now who actually build charging stations that are like a credit card charging station where you drive your car up to it, you plug it in, and strata corporations are now faced with people needing to charge their cars. Otherwise, what's happening is if somebody's using a simple charging center, that might be coming out of the common expenses of the corporation.
Right.
You know, why is the corporation essentially paying for the gas of this owner? Good question, but why are you not creating some charging stations to be able to accommodate electric
cars?
And
in some parts of British Columbia, not down here in the Lower Mainland or Southern Vancouver Island necessarily, but a lot of parking, common parking, includes a plug-in for the block heater, because without that plug-in, you're hooped. You're not going anywhere tomorrow morning at 6 a.m.
Well, that is certainly a greater problem, especially up north and in the Kootenays.
Yeah, of course,
Certainly places like Whistler, the resort properties, many of those are provided as a courtesy.
Okay.
They're low draw, it's a common expense, but it's provided as courtesy in the buildings. Many underground parking garages, though, in a lot of these areas are also heated because of the mechanical systems that are in the underground areas. They can't be unheated, so there may not necessarily be a need for that. But there are all kinds of facilities and services that come into these buildings that strata corporations have the ability to charge some user fees on. And certainly parking is one, additional storage lockers is another, user fees for charging stations, that's another.
Now, Adrian, you were talking during one of our breaks about some of these new developments in the city core, in Yale Town, in Vancouver, for example. There are multiple condo towers going up, and many of the occupants or eventual occupants will not have cars and require parking spaces, but there are parking areas, and some of these parking lots become stratas all themselves, don't they?
Exactly. We've got a number of developments, maybe less than half a dozen that I'm aware of, where it's an airspace parcel type of development where the land and the air above it are designated into parcels of land. But what that ultimately results in is individual strata corporations of residential towers, and then a separate strata corporation of just parking spaces. So
you would buy an apartment from the people who built the tower, and you would buy your parking spot from the people who built the parkade.
Who built the parking, and it would be completely different strata plan numbers.
Ah.
Your parking, you would have strata lot number 204 in the residential tower, perhaps strata lot 102, which is a parking space in the parking strata development.
But then because of that setup, though, you'd never be in a situation like Doris, who was our emailer of the week, who's just quite confused. She's still not sure whether she thinks she owns a parking spot and may or may not. If you buy a parking spot separately,
you have a title to it. You can search the title to that strata lot. You're shown as the registered owner. You have the strata plan number. It's equivalent to owning the residential strata lot. You own it. You'll pay taxes on it.
Okay. Now, that is still a new kind of thing. I'd like to just spend the last couple of minutes with both of you. Best practice bit of advice to potential buyers with respect to storage lockers and parking spaces as part of the package you want to buy.
Well, Sterling, I think I said it earlier. Strata corporations have to create parking plans. They need to create a plan showing what the allocations are for parking. They need to understand whether there were agreements, whether there are any limited common property designations filed. They need to have all their records and documents in hand. And if they don't have them, they're not going to be able to prepare for January 1st, 2014, which is another problem. Without all these documents, essentially, the strata corporation is in the dark, the same way sellers and buyers are. are. So it's essential that they put together the records of the strata corporation that will help them form their parking plans, show the designations, the allocations, and then understand what flexibilities they have within those parking plans. They may have none. Absolutely every parking space may be allocated to the sense the strata has no flexibility at all. But they may have some, and it's essential that they know what those may be.
Interesting. Adrian?
Don't assume.
Yeah.
If you are the buyer and you're being told it comes with a parking space or it comes with a storage locker, ask the questions. What is my legal entitlement to use that area? And the fact that the seller may have used it, or the seller said it came with the strata lot, or I've been using it for the last 10 years, it must be mine, isn't good enough. You want to look at the strata plan. Talk to your realtor. And make sure your realtor asks questions.
Mm-hmm. Right, yep. And so basically, and great advice from a lawyer, show me some evidence.
Exactly.
If I'm going to spend all this dough, by gosh, I need it written down exactly what I'm getting. And if you're not going to be prepared to show me that evidence, I'm not doing the deal.
And if at the worst case, as a buyer, go to the Strata Council and say, I'm tending to buy unit 204.
Yeah.
What parking is going to be assigned to me? Get the Strata Council, even in advance of that parking plan, get them to tell you today in writing that this parking space will be allocated.
If you buy
to
such
you.
And such an apartment, you will automatically get.
We will allocate unit 204, parking space 24 to you.
Lots of money involved here, Tony. Lots of details to look after, and without all of them signed off, why spend the money?
Parking can be a substantial addition to your asset of the corporation, an additional asset to your purchase as a unit, right? Whether everyone has a vested interest in this parking, so it's incumbent upon the Strata Corporation, the owners, the buyers, the sellers, everyone to identify this clearly.
Look for Tony Gioventu's condo columns in the Thursday edition of 24 Hours and every Sunday in the Vancouver province. Adrian Murray, thanks so much for coming back to visit with us. It was a treat.
My pleasure.
And do come and see us again.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I'm Sterling Fox. We'll see you next time.